Hello, my name is Charlotte Holland. Welcome to my TV show. It's called Selah. Selah is a Hebrew word. It means stop, pause, and think about it. Thank you so much for watching Selah on TV 20 on Comcast Cable. Thank you, Detroit. God bless you. Everybody, I'm losing my voice. That's okay. I'm going to get it out. God bless you exceedingly and abundantly, more than you can ever ask or think, and your family. And speaking of family, tell somebody Selah is on the air. And when it airs, it's going to be 2017, so Happy New Year. And we did one, and I didn't say Happy Hanukkah or Happy Kwanzaa from the last one, the last program we did, the previous one that came on or that will air in December 2016, but I don't want to leave anybody out. Whatever you're celebrating, be happy and enjoy your life and keep God first and enjoy your family and your friends. Well, the topic today, I'm skipping around because I got to thank those that are watching on the network too, but the topic is make the list. Don't forget what God has already done. Make the list. Make you a list. I got one. I've done this about four times. And I seen War Room 10 times. And then I ended up making, I set up a room and it was just like this. Don't forget. It was like remembering what God had done. So that was how my room was set up. And I'm just telling you, make your list, because if you're going through and you have problems and you're going through the valley, if you're like tore up from the floor up, if you're dealing with fear, if it's sickness, if it's physical, if it's family related, whatever the problem is, we serve a big God. He's a mighty God. Praise Him, because He is the way, the truth, and the life. He is the way. So we're talking about the topic, make the list. So I made a list that I might share with you today, and I'm going to introduce my special guest, and he's going to also share, and we want to help you. We want to bless you today, and we want you to continue to watch Selah on bgntvgospel.com, which stays on 24 hours a day. We come on the fourth Sunday at 2 p.m. with a new topic. And you don't want to miss this, because it's a blessing. We are here for you. We are blessed to be a blessing. My guest, he's blessed to be a blessing. Missionary John, who you will hear from shortly. He's a mighty, mighty, mighty man of God. He's a good man. And being a godly man is different from just being a man, a regular average man. You know, you got fathers, but they're not godly fathers. You got men in the home, and they're not godly men. You got men, they don't know the Lord. I heard somebody say one time, real men love Jesus. I heard that, and I believe that. Again, the topic, make the list. Make your own list. And don't forget, on this list, is don't forget what God has already done. And if you make this list, you can keep it in your Bible. And whenever you're feeling bad and you have problems and the circumstance looks hopeless and whatever it is, and it's like stealing your joy, then just pull out your list. And I just found that little book of prayers couldn't find earlier. But when you make your list and you read your list and read it out loud, you will feel better. It will change the atmosphere. You won't feel as bad. I promise you. I use it, and I have problems like everybody else. I'm human. And I'm using a scripture from Psalm chapter 103, verses 1 through 5. I want you to do that and pull that up yourself, too. And that Psalm chapter, that's the one I think. Is that the one that says, bless the Lord, O my soul? And So that is, he's talking about benefits. And but that one is, again, Psalm chapter 103, verses 1 through 5. And I want to thank you.
If you like.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I am. And I thank you again for watching the network, because we couldn't do it without Elder Choir Boy Bell. Bless you, brother, and your family. And a shout out too, as I say Happy New Year to my family and to everybody that's watching. And you are definitely on my prayer list. So the year is starting out, and you don't want it to be like it was last year. We're praying that it's better. And you have many testimonies. Glory to God.
Yes, first of all, let me introduce you. This is Missionary John, and he's going to give you his last name and give you a little bit of information about himself. And then he's going to read Psalm chapter 103, verses 1 through 5, because we're making a list, and we don't want you to forget what God has already done, because if he did it before, he can do it again. Amen.
This is Psalm 103, a Psalm of David. My name is Missionary John. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. We sing that song. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Verse 2. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. I think that's an important word right there. Forget not.
Mm-hmm.
And I forget a lot of things. That's why I make a list. And I make a list and check it. Verse 3, who forgives all your iniquities and heals all your diseases. Now that's something to thank the Lord for.
Yes.
That he gave us salvation, he forgave us of all our sins, and healed us. You know, if you're sick right now and your body's hurting, listen to your body, because pain is a gift from God. It lets you know something's wrong, just like a warning light on your dashboard of your car. So, think back about how the Lord's healed you in the past and healed other people. And verse 4, who redeems your life from the pit, who crowns you with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfies your mouth with good things so that their youth is renewed like the eagles. I like that.
Hallelujah.
Isaiah 40:31, they that wait upon the Lord shall mount up on wings as eagles, run and not be weary, walk and not faint. Isaiah 40:31. So count your blessings, name them one by one, and the Lord has blessed you. And you can sing that song, count your blessings, name them one by one, and it will surprise you what the Lord has done.
Amen. You know what? The word is just quick and active and alive and powerful and more sharper than a two-edged sword. I enjoyed you reading that, but now I want you to sing a little bit of that song.
Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one, and it will surprise you what the Lord has done.
Amen. Did you want to tell them a little bit about you?
Well, you know, that song reminds me, when I was pastoring a church in Harlem, Montana, near an Indian reservation, there was a lady that... Every time we had a prayer request from Hymns of Glorious Praise, the Assembly of God hymn book, she said, I want, count your blessings. So that's why I really learned to appreciate that song. And when I've been in some hard times, I think back about how the Lord has been faithful in the past. And that helps me deal with the present and think about the future. And the very first thing that I think about on my list is salvation. February 25th, 1975, at the First Assembly of God Church in Bay City, Michigan, I was born again, became a new creature in Christ. My life changed 180 degrees in a new direction towards God. Before, drinking, drugs, sex, Eastern religions, but now changed in 180 degrees in a new direction toward God, and I began to read the Bible, pray, witness, and fellowship. And so that's my first blessing, is salvation. And then I was baptized in the Holy Spirit, spoke in tongues in Singapore, and I began to pray more and more in the Spirit and build up the inner man, and it helped me a lot. A third blessing is God's protection. And I think about the whole armor of God. And every day I put it on by faith. I go from top to bottom.
Yes.
I do exercises, helmet of salvation, breastplate of righteousness, belt of truth, shoes of the gospel of peace, shield of faith,
yes,
to stop the flaming arrows of the enemy. And the three flaming arrows that shoot down most Christians are sex, money, and pride. Sex outside of marriage, love of money, and pride, thinking of yourself more highly than you should. Or the three G's, gold, glory, and girls, or gold, glory, and guys. And some people add a fourth G, grumpy. So we got to have the shield of faith and then the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God.
Amen.
So we read the Word of God, memorize the Word of God, and we use it as the sword of the Spirit, the offensive weapon. And then all prayer and supplication. What are we talking about? Ephesians 6, 10 to 20. Put on the whole armor of God. The blood of Jesus cover you from head to toe with all prayer and supplication, praying all times in the Spirit. So I'm thanking the Lord. Number one, my list, salvation, being baptized in the Holy Spirit. And then three, God's protection. I think those are the three ones that come to the top of my list right there.
Amen. I got to put those on my list, but some of them are. They might not be in his order, but I put some on my phone this morning. And on my list, like I said, this is my fourth one. On the list I have, and your list is going to be different, and it's okay. It's your list, but make one, please. Try it. Do you remember what God has already done? How soon we forget, right? Okay. I have on here, let's see. Well, I said it earlier. If you're in trouble and if you're depressed, if you're upset about something, things aren't going well, and then you want to pull your list out and then of what God has already done, how he's blessed you, because he is still in the blessing business. And I put down here, this God just gave this to me. Pull out your list if you need a spiritual booster shot or any victory vitamins. Now, that came from the Holy Throne this morning, about 5 a.m. And I put, don't forget what he's already done on my list. The number one I had, he gave me life. And so that, to me, you can say that's salvation, but I was thinking more like when I came here, when I was born. But then born again, see. And then I have my family. That's another blessing. You know, he gave me, I mean, the family is not perfect. I'm not perfect. You're not perfect. It's always room for improvement. And friends. You can have friends and they're just like family. You love each other and you want to spend time with them. And you want to be a blessing to them too. And they will bless you as well. It's like not one-sided. They are there for you. And then I have down here on my list, you took my sins away and suffered and died for me. So here we go, put to the salvation, you know, that being crucified for me, I take it personal and I get emotional about it. I love the Lord. And he was on that cross, oh my God, and it saved my soul. And in John chapter 3, verse 16, chapter 3, verse 16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, and whoever believes in him will not perish, but have everlasting or eternal life. So that's on my list. I don't want to forget.
Let me read that to you right here. This book here is called the Arabic English Bible, New Testament. And John 3:16 in this Arabic and English Bible is so important. It's a priority that one of the first things I do is memorize this in different languages. So John chapter 3 verse 16, it says, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. Now look right here, this is Arabic, and you can see it maybe on the camera, but that's the Arabic language. They read right to left. See, this is the front, this is the back. The original Bible was written in Hebrew, and it reads right to left like in Arabic.
And the Jews, they the same thing.
Yeah.
Right to left.
So look at this. Liannahu hakata ahab Allah ilalam hata badle ibnuhu al wahid lakela yelet kulman yoman bihi bal tukun al hayat labadia. And
wow.
In Turkish, chunku tanre dunyayi o kadar chok sevdeki birajik olnu verde oile ki ona iman edinlerin hich viri malvomasin amahepsi sansu jashama kavush sun. John 3:16 in Turkish. And I was running in the Istanbul Marathon, the only marathon in the world on two continents. You start in Asia and you finish in Europe and you run over this big bridge. And I was coming alongside runners and I'd come right behind them and alongside them, and I'd quote this to them in John 3:16. And there was two guys with fist-sized beards and they cut me off when they heard me say, for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son. Because in Islam, it says God has no son. And so I said, well, praise the Lord anyway. And I took off and passed him. And so I've run 33 marathons. And that was one of my favorites, quoting John 3:16 in Turkish to Turkish Muslims while running. But I love fitness and physical fitness and sports, but my life verse, 1 Timothy 4:8, physical fitness is all right, but spiritual fitness is much more important because it helps you not only in this life, but the next life too. So thank you for letting me comment on John 3:16.
Amen. No problem. That's one of my favorites. And don't you forget also what God has already done, because that's on my list. And then I have so many, but you just jump in there anytime, okay? And I got that Jesus taught me how to pray. He saved my life and healed me many times, several times. And you could probably agree that you out there watching, I know that he has got you out of your sick bed before, or somebody that you know or a loved one, and saved you, maybe from a car accident. And let's see. And he also, in the healing, I have down here, I don't want to forget what he's already done. That's what this list is about. He gave me body parts when I needed body parts. And that's a whole nother program.
You better explain that a little bit.
Well, I needed, he gave me new lungs.
Okay.
3 times. So we'll talk about that. We'll do that on another program. So that was on my list. I don't want to forget that he did that. I want you to know that in case you're waiting for, you need a transplant or...
Were you ever a smoker?
No, never.
Wow.
No.
And for those of you that are smoking, ask the Lord to give you better lungs. You got to stop smoking. You got to do your part and God will do his part.
That's right.
So you got to stop. And this is a time for a prayer. Lord, I pray for everybody that's watching this show that who are smoking cigarettes mm-hmm. or any kind of tobacco. Lord, I pray that they'd find deliverance in the name of Jesus mm-hmm. from cigarette addiction, nicotine addiction, mm-hmm. tobacco addiction. Mm-hmm. Lord, heal their bodies. And Lord, you could replace their lungs, the damaged tissue, and they could be healed. Just like
Glory.
Sister Charlotte mm-hmm. has been healed and mm-hmm. her lungs have been healed. God can do that
3 times.
You and your other friends that are smokers, Lord.
Yes.
So Lord, help them to call on the name of Jesus for deliverance from addiction to tobacco, in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Amen.
And also, I'll add to that, any kind of addiction, because it could be some other bad habits there. It could be alcohol. Mm-hmm. You could be popping pills. Sometimes the doctors even prescribe them, and you get hooked on them, and you depend on them, and they become a habit. Mm-hmm. You know, you got to be careful, because sometimes they have side effects, and that's another problem. But any addiction, you know, drugs, lust. So we include that in that prayer in Jesus' name. For those of you who are watching who might have those problems or those issues going on in your life and you think, oh, nobody knows and you're kind of keeping it a secret and you're ashamed, somebody knows. God knows. He hears and sees everything. And he can help you. And we prayed for you. So you don't have to stay on that.
And there's also something that you need to do. You just don't pray about it. But when I'm out running or bicycling and... there's some beautiful woman jogging towards me or bicycling or whatever, I sing this song to myself. Look away, look away, look away, Beulah Land. And I look at God's creation, the trees and the sky, and I get blessed.
Amen. That's awesome.
You got to have bouncing eyeballs sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Especially the way some of the females, we dress. Sometimes it's too revealing or might be too short or too tight. And I feel sorry for the men because they might be maybe like a little top heavy or maybe it's the a low cut. And anyway, you know who you are.
And the Lord will deliver it, but you got to do your part. You got to choose to look away. Don't just stare.
Amen. And also, don't forget what God has already done. That's on my list. Is that he has blessed me down through the years with many positions as far as jobs and passing all the tests. And I don't like taking tests, but I pass all of them.
Praise God.
I pass all of them, and I have to praise him and not forget, because I would get nervous and just stiffen up and thought negative. You know, it was a negative thought, like I'm not going to make it, I'm not going to get hired. But anyway, he blessed me with many good jobs. And I got promoted many times, and I can't forget what he's already done. And blessed me with a good husband and with three wonderful children and eight grandchildren.
Praise God.
And that I don't want to forget that, because some women have never been married. And some people don't even have children. You know, so I don't want to take anything for granted. So I don't want to forget that I was blessed to have been married for 30 years. And I have three children. They're adults now. And I have eight wonderful grandchildren. And on my list, I don't want to ever forget what God has already done. I had traveled. We traveled. The family traveled by train, bus, car. We went on cruises, airplanes in the U.S. and several countries, including the Holy Land in Jerusalem in Israel. And I went first as a tourist, you know, but then the next time I went as a missionary. And the missionary is different from just going on vacation.
Yeah, I was in Israel myself. The first time I was riding my bicycle around the world and 36 countries, 4.5 years preaching the gospel.
Woo!
So when I got to Israel, I bicycled from Sharm el-Sheikh to Matula for 3 months and witnessed to the Jews and the Arabs and had a wonderful time. And the second time I took my youngest son when he graduated from college to do the footsteps of Jesus. So I just didn't jump on and off a bus like the normal tourists, but we went by Israeli bus and we hiked the mountains and swam in the seas, and it was a wonderful experience. So it's a good idea to try to make it to Israel someday. It helps bring the Bible alive. Somebody once said, when I read the Bible at home, it was like reading the Bible in black and white. But when you go to Israel and see the geography of the Holy Lands, he says it's like reading the Bible in color.
Yes, yes. We got a few minutes left here, and I still have some things on my list, but make a list, and it works. Call me. And I really believe that somebody out there that's watching Selah right now, I'm going to get a sponsor, maybe more than one, an earthly sponsor. Right now, we've been on the air this year, 2016, as of July, 5 years. God is my sponsor, so that's why I'm on. But I want an earthly sponsor, or maybe more than one. And in my heart, I really believe that my first sponsor and whoever sponsors Selah is going to really, really, really get blessed. And God is going to thank you in His way and in His timing. I had to get that in. And then back to the list, and don't forget what God has already done. And I got down here that we had many cars. My husband always had a used car. He wanted to pay for it and not have a note. And some of you can understand that. Me, as a female, I wanted to lease and trade it in every year, every other year, and I wanted a new car. So, but that was a blessing. So I count that as not forgetting that we not only had one car, we had two. And we had a new one, and we also had a used car. And that is, I don't want to forget about that, the transportation. Because some people don't have a car, and I pray right now that you will get transportation, or if you're having car problems, that it won't be costly, and that you'll get it back in a timely fashion. And I just pray that those needs are met, and you'll be safe behind the wheel. And when you drive, and when somebody else is driving, wherever you are, whether it's day or night, on the freeway, on the regular residential street, be safe and protected. I'm praying protection over you, the viewers, right now. Not just driving with cars, but any form of transportation. And it could be the children on the school buses, because the kids just went back to school. So thank you, Jesus, for hearing and answering our prayers. And thy will be done in Jesus' name by your blood. And that just popped up. But on the list, we don't want to forget what God has already done. And He's done so many things. Your list will go on and on and on. It will never stop, because God will never stop blessing you. He's in the blessing business. And I have down here also, we had an apartment. We had two beautiful homes and good neighbors. We're in a nice neighborhood. Don't forget that. Don't forget that. Like, I have some things going on, problems in the home right now as far as repairs and water damage. But I'm thankful, and I can't forget that I have a roof over my head. Problems or not, I do have a house. So I'm thankful for my house. I love my house, and everything will be all right. In fact, what's on my spirit right now, there's a song, I don't know how old it is, but if you've ever heard of Minister Shirley Caesar, she had a song called You Can Make It. I strongly suggest that you pull it up on the internet or get the CD or pull it up on your smartphone, on YouTube. Listen to every lyric all the way, beginning to the end. You Can Make It is the name of that song. And that song is encouraging, and it will bless your socks off. And then I have on my list, don't forget what he's already done, is that the scripture, the joy of the Lord is our strength, in Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 10. And that I put that down on the list.
Because I like that song. The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength.
Yes.
The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength.
Yes. And then I can see, I have a friend named, shout out to my daughter friend, Darice Ray. She's an author, and she'll be back again. And if you haven't seen her on Selah yet, pull it up, and she will minister to you. And she's a blessing. But she's blind, and she was a victim of domestic violence. But I thought of her, and I'm saying shout out to you, because you were going to be here today, and you wanted to be here, and things just didn't happen where you were to be here. But you will come back. God bless you and your family and your daughter. I just pray that she gets that position, that job, and everything works out for her. In Jesus' name, by Amen. His blood and his word. Amen. And then on the list I have here that I can see. I'm not blind. And on my list, I just don't forget that you gave me eyesight. Some people are born blind. That's not me. That wasn't me. I'm thankful. And then I can walk. I'm thankful for my legs. And you supply all of our needs in Philippians chapter 4, verse 19. So that I'm not forgetting what you've done. You have taken good care of me. You mm-hmm. always have, mm-hmm. always will. And thank you're taking care of them out there watching. Mm-hmm. And he Jesus. Is always with us. So I'm not going to forget what you've already done.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
And you've done so much. And you're still blessing us mm-hmm. and our families. You're not finished with us yet. Mm-hmm. And I have on my list, don't forget that food. Some we take things for granted.
Give us this day our daily bread.
Daily bread. Mm-hmm. And that's where I met you.
That's right.
I met you at a, how did we meet?
It's a conference, Our Daily Bread. Lord, thank you so much for blessing this. And we just pray that you'd bless these people. It's from you, to you, and through you, to you be the glory forever and ever.
Yes. Selah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you.
My name is Mike Duggan, and I'm watching the Bell Global Network.
Hey, keep it locked. It's your boy, D. Hattie, watching the Bell Global Network. You know how it is.
Hi, I'm Charlie Langton, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
Hi, this is Martha Reeves, and you're watching Bell Global Network.
Thing that happened to me that was good, God did it. I'm Evelyn Turrentine, AG, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
This is Pastor D. Alexander Bullock, the Preachers of Detroit, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
This is Bishop Edgar Van of Second Ebenezer Church in Detroit, Michigan, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
Hi, I'm Bernadette Stannis. You know me best as Thelma from the TV show Good Times, and you are watching Bell Global Network.
What's going on, y'all? It's Mr. Bell. Some know me as Antoine Quadboy Bell. Others know me as Elder Anton Bell. I am co-CEO of Bell Global Network, VGN TV 2090. And I want to invite you right now to get your own broadcast, calling all ministries, all politicians, all business owners. Get your own broadcast right now, starting at $99. And if you have an idea for a TV show, we can bring your idea to reality. We have a package that's available that includes production and facilities. Also, we have advertising packages starting at $25. So don't hesitate. Give us a call at 313-355-7877. Once again, that's 313-355-7877 to make an appointment today.
You never ever let me down, and when I'm sinking in sin, you never ever let me